What's going on, guys? Welcome in to Wonderlands. I'm excited to share this demo with you guys. Now, first and foremost, I'm not saying these words live. I'm recording this back on February the 19th, so a little bit earlier than what you're seeing this. That said, if you don't want any sort of spoilers whatsoever, by all means, go ahead and abandon ship now. Wait till the 25th when the game comes out and be completely surprised by everything. I'm cool with that. I fully understand that. I get that. That said, there will be absolutely zero story spoilers. No story spoilers whatsoever. What this demo is it is one big side quest. It's about 2 hours, 2 to 3 hours, depending on, you know, I'm going into this having already played this several times, so I know where everything's at and what to do. I think the first time I played this, I put in like a good 5 hours. So keep that in mind. And again, this is just a side quest. This demo gives us two playable character options. The first one is the Graveborn and the second one is the Stabomancer. I'm going to choose Stabomancer. The reason why is because Graveborn does not give you the ability to respec. As a matter of fact, let's do this. I'm going to pull up Graveborn first. I'll show you guys the skill tree for Graveborn, and then we'll switch back to Stabomancer and actually do the playthrough on that character. I don't know why they chose not to let us choose our own skill tree layout with this one, but now if you don't want to see the skill trees at all, now's a good time to abandon ship on that. Real quick, I'll show you guys the map while we got this up here. Map is a lot like the Borderlands 3 map. You can zoom in, zoom out. You can see the terrain, the elevations and all that fun stuff. It's a pretty big map. This is a side quest map and it's pretty big. We'll go through all the other things here real quick. There's going to be like your quest log, like what we had before. This quest log feels, once we get it filled up, it feels a lot better than the Borderlands 3 quest log, where I don't know, there was just something about the Borderlands 3 quest log that it felt really clunky most of the time. Like you would be scrolling down and then it would jump back up to the top. This one does not feel that way at all. This one feels smooth as butter. Everything that I've done so far, I've had no issues whatsoever. Inventory. This is the layout. A lot of people were worried that the melee weapon would take up one of your weapon slots. It does not. So you've got your traditional 4 weapons, plus you've got a melee weapon slot. You still have your traditional inspect item thing, which will also give you details and also show you the parts of the weapons as well. So that's really good on that too. In terms of the other stuff down here, the other gear, they've given us more things that we can now customize our character with. The build variety is going to be insane. Just number one, right off the bat, the build variety is going to be insane. We're going to have 2 rings or bands, I guess they're calling them. One slot is unlocked right now. The other slot, I guess we don't unlock until later on in the story, perhaps. We've got wards, which are shields. Then the thing right to the right of this is called, I think it's called a pendant, and that you unlock when you can do multi-classing. Then we've got this is basically your class mod. As you can see, it gives you some berserker power and it gives you a couple of other bonus stats there, but I found some that are much, much better than that. Then you got your spell slot, and spells are awesome, man. I dramatically prefer spells over grenades, having done them for a little bit. As I do this playthrough, I'll show you guys a bunch. All right, now the skill trees. If you want, pause this and read over everything. So we'll start with the top. So the Demi-Lich Companion, and then you got your 2 different skill options. You got Dire Sacrifice or Reaper of Bones. Then you've got your skills themselves, and I'm going to go through each one of these one by one. So feel free again to pause it and check things out as you please. There's your capstone. All right, so the first thought that I had when I saw that it's a single skill tree, and it's probably the same thought that you guys all had. Oh no, they've taken away our skill trees. But the more I think about this, the more I like it, and the more that I think that we will have more build variety, because number one, we're gonna have multi-classing, which means you're gonna have the ability to combine this skill tree plus one of, you know, 5 other skill trees. So that's a lot more build variety in just that alone. But then they also have this new option down here in the bottom right called Hero Stats. So if you click on this, you can see that you got strength, dexterity, intelligence, wisdom, constitution, and attunement options. And you know, you can, you know, build these any way you want, spending your points in there how you want. Again, the bad thing about this demo is they did not let us change any of this on this character for whatever reason. And then finally, you have Myth Rank. Now, Myth Rank, this unlocks at level 40, and I'm guessing that's going to be kind of like Guardian Rank was in Borderlands 3, where you get some other bonus stats that you can then unlock. And here's the Lich Companion, in case you guys are wondering about that. We'll switch over to the Stabomancer. So we'll play Demo Stabomancer, and let's try this one out. So I hope you guys are enjoying this. If you're watching again, if you're watching on Twitch, thank you guys for being here. If you're watching these highlights on YouTube, thank you. Hopefully none of this is anything that's too spoilery for you guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy this. So let's show you guys the Stabomancer. Now, like I said, with the Stabomancer, I actually get to choose where I put my skill points. It gave me a lot more options here. They're starting us off with 8 skill points, and that's at level 9. So it looks like we unlock our first skill point when we hit our first level up at level 2. The action skill, or what they're calling the class feat, is Dirty Fighting. This increases your critical hit chance by 30%. Really awesome. This character is all about doing good melee damage, doing great crit damage. So we're going to really highly focus that. So first action skill option, there's 2 action skill options for each character, at least so far as I know. There's only 2 characters that we got to play on this demo, which again, Graveborn and Stabomancer. And now I'm just going to cycle through the skill tree and let you guys see each of these things as well. And again, feel free to pause and read anything that you want, or clip this if you're watching on Twitch, clip it, and then, you know, you've got it for playback. Now we go into our hero stat. I'm going to put all of my points in strength, so I get that extra 10% crit damage. I just want to max out crit damage. I want to be like a crit machine with this character. From my play testing on this, the crossbow variants of guns, really good. Really, really good. If you find yourself a Jacob's pistol that says that it's only 1 mag size, don't be scared of it. Try it out. You will be surprised. And then we got our melee weapon. We got a doll that's a crossbow variant as well. So we got really good starting gear on this character. You do have 3 difficulty options you can change between. So you've got relaxed. You're here to chill with the little imaginary people that live on your screen and save the whole dang world while you're at it. Players deal more damage. Enemies deal less damage. Using the correct element damage for an enemy matters less. Then you got balanced. You're here for the thrilling battle between good and evil. The intended Tiny Tina's Wonderlands experience. This is your traditional play. This is what most people will do. They'll do balanced. And then you've got intense. You're here to destroy all evil, no matter what foul screaming hordes the Bunker Master sends your way. Players deal less damage, enemies deal more damage, bonuses to gold and moon orb drops. Using the correct element damage for an enemy matters more. So we'll just go ahead and throw it on balanced. First and foremost, as you guys can't tell, this game is beautiful, dude. This game is absolutely beautiful. Right down to like the moss on the rocks. I was in love the first time I came around this curve and I saw just the look of this thing, man. Absolutely love it. Let's go ahead and start talking about some of the quality of life changes. Number one, you know how you have to normally hit square and open up those things or whatever button you use on whatever thing you are on? Well, guess what? Now you can slide into chests to open them, or you can smack them open. Pretty dope, right? But that's not all. You can also jump and ground slam, and you don't need to have a guardian rank to do that. You can now jump and ground slam from your regular jump height. That's another quality of life change right there that I like a lot. The vending machines also have another really cool change. So, you know, normally you can just refill all your ammo from just walking up to the machine. Let's go into our inventory and let's go ahead and mark off the skulldugger, this thing, and this spell. And now check this out. If you come to these machines, the one that has the Buttstallion image on it, you now have the option to sell all your junk with a click of a button. You no longer need to like go in and actually, you know, go to your sell thing, or go in and then swap over to a thing and then hit sell all junk. You can now sell all junk while running past the machine, essentially. It's a pretty cool feature. This is a great way to open 2 chests at once, by the way. Just the jump and ground slam. You can get 2 chests open at the same time. I love this, man. I love this. I love everything. Let me tell you guys, I played, to this point, I've played already 22 hours of this demo. And this demo, again, is essentially like a 2 to 2.5 hour loop once you know where everything's at. And I've already gotten like 2 days worth of game time in. So definitely, definitely feeling good about Wonderland so far. Look at this place, man. Absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Of course, sliding and mantling are back. You can still slide a mantle. There's your mantle. Gunplay feels even tighter than it did on Borderlands 3. Tighter in terms of like better. I don't know if that makes sense. Like, I feel more accurate than I did even on Borderlands 3. There's our spell cast right there. Launched a meteor at that guy. Let's go ahead and pop our action skill so you guys can see this. So as you can see, you can tell it where to move the blade. So even if they fly out of it, you can like move it to them and keep chopping them up. Now, while this is a cool action skill and all, I actually prefer the other action skill. I actually prefer to swap over to From the Shadows. This to me is kind of like Fadeaway and kind of like Deception for Zero. Really like this ability. Even if you're not super accurate with your meteors, they seem to have a pretty good radius. One of the cool things is, you know how like in previous Borderlands games, there were so many things that we could like collect, like vault symbols. Like just finding vault symbols was cool. It was something to collect. Well, they've taken that up a notch in this game, and they've given us these golden dice. Let's go ahead and spin it. And as you can see, it says 1 out of 19. We rolled a 13, that's not horrible. And we ended up getting a class mod out of it. Now you can tell this one's for Clawbringer, so it doesn't help me, but I can sell it, it's worth money. But as you find all of these dice, the more dice you find, the better your luck for loot will be throughout the entirety of the map. So make sure that whenever you find these dice, you go spin them as quick as you can, because it's gonna increase your luck. Let's show you guys the melee weapons. I haven't showed you these guys yet. There is no melee cooldown. Swipe as much and as fast as you want. But different weapons have different speeds. So that was the flat blade of the assassin. Let's try a great axe. You can see the great axe is slower, but it's generally stronger. But we'll get some other melee stuff as we go here as well. And with any luck, maybe we'll even find like a legendary along the way. Pretty much every playthrough I've done, I've found one legendary. Legendaries definitely aren't as common in this game as they were in Borderlands 3. I know that was a concern that a lot of people had. Kicking Barrels is back, by the way. Unlike Borderlands 3, you don't have to shoot it like 3-4 times to get it to blow up. You can kick it, it goes flying, you shoot it once, and guess what? It blows up, which means you have a much better chance of being able to use barrels to actually kill enemies. You don't have to like be super accurate with the barrel. And you can still slide and punch to launch them further. As you can see there, we launched that thing way up there. And still hurt enemies with barrels, obviously. Barrels just in general feel even better than before, which is wild because they already felt great. Ground slams tend to knock enemies down, stagger them, or at least knock them back a lot of times. Here's the camo. Gonna use this thing. So you guys can see this. That guy blew up on me. So you guys can see the speed of the camo there. This is probably my favorite melee weapon type. This one's a lot faster, so it's less powerful. But again, you know, that first hit, you can often stagger enemies. And a new spell. We'll tinker around with some spells as we go. So that spell that we just now got is a dark magic spell. Try that thing out. That's basically the Wonderlands version of healing yourself. So as you can see right there, this TDR actually felt pretty good. And check that out. On throw reload, this TDR spawns in Hydras that fight for me. Check it out, I can throw a few of these in. They're gonna pop up all over the place and do the work for me. I completely whiffed on that spell. Let's go From the Shadows. And as you can see, From the Shadows basically makes you like a Megavore flak. Everything you do is a crit, including body shots. So definitely worth messing around with that. Here's a new spell. This one's poison damage, which is basically like this game's corrosion. But then we also got a fire spell. Most of the enemies that we're gonna encounter are gonna be weak to fire, so we're gonna use that. All right, now this one is a hold to summon. And we get blood wings. As you can see, I've already unlocked this armor collar customization, but you'll notice that it's worth 194 gold as opposed to like the old Borderlands 3 one gold, which is, you know, obviously not ideal. So on this game, they definitely made it a little nicer when you find customizations, even if you already had them, that they're at least worth money now, you know what I mean? So definitely like that. Ooh, all right, level up. There's level 10, just like that. And ooh, another Jacobs. This one is not a crossbow attachment, as you can see. We'll pick that up and try it out. 4 mag. Here's a new spell. This one is also dark magic. Slap that thing on, try it out. And he dropped me a stovepipe of discipline. All right, so check this thing out. This is, these are energy weapons, essentially. So as you can see, the barrel, it looks badass, right? It looks badass. But at least as of the time of me recording this, and we've reported this to Gearbox, they feel kind of weak, I'll be honest. But we'll, you know, I'll use it and see what you guys think. Let's go and put our point here. And every time you level up, you get 1 skill point and 1 hero point. I'm going to be going all strength for this build because I want to get that crit damage to be as high as possible. See how we do with this energy weapon. But you see, it just feels kind of weak. I don't know what Gearbox needs to do about that, but it just doesn't feel that great. Just shine right in the donk. Oh, we got this guy coming at us. Got him. So you can see it's easy to go back and forth between melee and using guns. Easy peasy. The Jacob's pistols feel great. All right, so you guys saw the map that we've been in so far, right? The map that we've seen so far is this, right? That's, you know, pretty decent. That's a pretty decent little map so far. Well, guess what? Then you walk out these doors into this. This is a huge map. And we got a giant troll jailer over here. Need to go rescue some peoples. Oh, this is okay, cool. This pistol is one of the ones that shoots out saw blades, I think, isn't it? Yeah, this one shoots out saw blades, and saw blades deal 2% increased damage for each saw blade stuck in the target. You see, it's not the strongest thing in the world, but of course, this is a troll jailer. These guys are pretty tough. Here's another new enemy type, the dogfish or sharks. Sharks with legs. Hammerheads are basically the badass version of those. Try and use your best skills to take them out. Usually I like to hit them with a spell and pop my action skill. And then they can go under the ice and you can see their fins. You can shoot their fins to get them back up. Got some more side quests over here that we can do, even though we just now completed that one. I like this. He's like basically bippity-boppy reloading his weapon with the COVs, which these are skullduggers now, not COV. So COV doesn't exist in this timeline yet. Gotta watch out for these traps, man. You'll see those every once in a while in your chest. Ooh, a new doll assault rifle. All right, so let's put that on in place of the skulldugger, since I don't really like the skullduggers that much. If you guys play this game and you find a Hyperion, or Hyperius is the manufacturer now, a Hyperius SMG that has a x4 or any kind of multiplier, pick it up. You might be surprised. Oh yeah, Jacob's so good, dude. Jacob's is so good, dude. And I don't know if you guys have noticed, but visual pollution dramatically down from Borderlands 3. Thankfully. Thankfully, man. Pretty much every assault rifle I've tried so far on this game has felt pretty good, though. Another new cool collectible slash findable thing are these things right here. These are called Rune Switch. So basically, you activate this thing, and then you got to run and find each of the beacons that it spawns. It's going to spawn 3 beacons. Once you find all 3 beacons and click on them, then you will get rewarded. It'll give you some loot for doing that. We're going to come back to that, though. And in case you guys hadn't noticed up to this point, everything is running smooth as butter. No hitches, no glitches, no weird shit at all from what I've seen. I've only had the game crash on me once, and that was when I was spamming through a bunch of different graphic settings and changing a lot of graphic settings on the fly. I think that I just overwhelmed the game with all the choices that I was trying to hit it with, but that was the only time I've had any issue. Also, melee works from pretty far away. All right, here's a new spell for us to try out. Ooh, all right. New Jacobs. I'm going to go ahead and double back, and we're going to do that the rune thing. All right, go ahead and start running. It is a very generous timer, at least on this one. I don't know if they're all that generous, so I'm actually going to grab this chest while I'm doing it. So here's our first of the beacons. Did I still make it? I completely forgot about the third one. So you can see that it definitely gives you lots of time, huh? And we got a legendary. Okay, before I take a look at this, if anybody doesn't want to be spoiled by legendaries, now's the time to maybe turn away for a bit. I don't want to ruin any legendaries for anybody, so, you know, this is your chance. All right, you've been warned. Let's see what we got. It's an actual weapon. Fragment Reign of the Magician. This is actually the first weapon that I've gotten as a legendary, other than melee weapons. And we kind of took our sweet-ass time picking that thing up, too. to get into that beacon. The red text says, nothing burns like the cold. It says, thrown weapon explodes on impact, morphs into a Hydra companion, shooting at enemies for a duration. Well, let's try it out. See what it does. Ooh. All right. First, we've got a Hydra that pops out with it. Okay, so it looks like when you hit enemies, it ricochets out and tracks down other enemies. Holy crap. Holy crap. This thing's actually pretty dope. Or at least it seems pretty dope. Oh my god. This is awesome, dude. I love finding new gear. So basically every playthrough run I've done at this point, I've gotten something good. Except for the very first one I did. I think the very first one I did, I didn't get any legendaries until after I started like replaying through the maps. I'm curious. Yeah, it looks like all these ricochets are hitting for crits too with the Stabomancer's ability. This is actually a pretty strong gun with the Stabomancer, it seems like. That guy's gonna blow up. I'm not getting anywhere near him. I learned my lesson last time. The healing. It's 2 ammo per shot, it looks like. So a little ammo heavy, but does do crazy good damage. But check this out. You know, normally in these maps, you get to like a certain point and you have to fast travel to go back to somewhere, or you have to run back. You can actually just drop over this ledge down to the this area over here. No longer do you need to go all the way around. You can actually just shortcut down to this. And as you can see, here's another cool thing that we can now look out for, these obelisks. So when you activate these, you're going to get some tougher enemies. And these tough enemies can, well, the final enemy that pops up is going to be a named enemy, and hopefully we get something cool from them. As you can see, this definitely gets pretty tough. All these enemies out here, man. Of course, that also gives you a chance to get second wins, too, which is nice. All right, there he is, Pigwort. All right, he teleports a lot. Even if you die, this guy does not despawn, so you don't have to worry about that. Oh my god, we got another legendary. Again, if you don't want any spoilers, turn away now. That's the first legendary I've ever gotten from that guy. So if you don't want to see what this thing is, now's the time for you to tune out, because I did not expect to get anything. Surprised that I did. Happy that I did. This was a nice tough fight. I feel rewarded for actually completing it by actually getting something maybe useful. All right, it looks like it's a legendary ward. An ancient deity of hail. Hear my words that I might teach you, is the red text. I don't know what that's in relation to, but if you guys know, let me know in the comments section down below. Pretty good elemental damage resistance, physical damage resistance, dark magic damage, and fire rate while your shield is depleted. Guys, who's this a reference to? Some of you will know. All right, how about a legendary? Oh my god. I can't believe that worked. All right, so once again, spoilers. You don't want to see the legendary. Turn away now. Can't believe we got 3 legendaries on this run. That's insane. And this one is a band, I guess is what they call it. It's Ally's Promise Ring of the Jinx. Red text says, wait for it. Ability critical hit damage, spell critical hit damage while action skill is ready. Effects are increased. So that is that, guys. That was the that was all the side quests. I don't know how long I was streaming this, but hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you hit that like button, hit subscribe, tap the bell icon for more. I will see you guys in the next video. Y'all take care.